Mom, story time with Dad. This is my favorite story time. Under the bed in my secret fort, and I'm gonna read.
Mary Poppins!
Well, here we are at Cherry Tree Lane, at number 17, and that's where the Binks family lives. And you know what, Mr. Binks, he works all day, and Mrs. Binks is always busy with club meetings, so Jane, the oldest, and then Michael, and the twins' children must have a nanny because the nanny just left. She just left. Can you believe that? So now they didn't have anyone to look after them, and they were being called little monsters, all of them. But they really weren't monsters. They just were simply misunderstood because the children ran to follow the kite. They didn't run away from the nanny. So Jane and Michael were in the room, and they're going, oh my gosh, how do we get a nanny? And the Constable Jones tried to explain that he brought the children home, but the nanny wouldn't listen, and now Mr. and Mrs. Bank had to find a solution. So they placed an advertisement in the newspaper calling for someone firm and sensible. But Jane and Michael came up with their own plan and wrote their own advertisement. Wanted, a nanny must have a cheery disposition, rosy cheeks, and be willing to play games. I love hide and seek. Oh, I like playing Legos. And the twins like playing toy soldiers. So when Mr. Banks saw the children's advertisement, he called it ridiculous nonsense. He tore it up, threw it in the fireplace, and wrote the advertisement himself. But late that night, a strange breeze blew down the bank's chimney and carried the pieces up in the night sky. Swirl, swirl, swirl. The pieces went up into the sky, and the wind blew. And the next morning, when Jane and Michael got up, the line of nannies they saw from their window stretched clear around the block. Oh my gosh, look at all those nannies. They're being interviewed by their dad, Mr. Banks, for a firm and sensible one. Not a rosy cheek, fun one. Jane looked from the window at the nannies in dismay. I don't understand, Michael. They're not what the advertisement we wrote at all. But just then, the wind started blowing from the east. Down Cherry Tree Lane, the east wind blew. Growing stronger and stronger and stronger. And oh my gosh, the ladies, the nannies, and line, they were like holding on to their coats and purses. And then before you knew it, there was no one there. And Jade and Michael watched in glee from the nursery window. Then riding towards them on the east wind, a person holding a black umbrella up in the air with a bag in her hand was flying. Michael, oh my gosh, there's a lady outside in the air flying. No way. Yes, way. Totally. And the rosy-cheeked person landed on the doorsteps of number 17. She promptly marched in and said, Mr. Banks, I am the new nanny. And before Mr. Banks could even say anything, she slid up the banister to the nursery. My name is Mary Poppins, she said, taking off her coat and hat. Come along, children. We will begin our games. Jane didn't like the sound of that. Are you sure it's a game, Mary Poppins? That depends on your point of view. You see, in every job, there must be done. There is an element of fun. You find the fun and step the job's a game. Do you see what I mean? One soldier, two soldier, three soldier, four soldier, five soldier, four, six soldier, five soldier, six soldier. She was saying soldiers and a strange accent. And then she took some medicine, and then she started to dance and sing. Just a spoonful of sugar, let the medicine go down. Medicine go down. Medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar, let the medicine go down. Let the medicine go down. La 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 la. Mary Poppins snapped her fingers, and sure enough, Let's Tidy Up the Nursery became a magical game. Toys put themselves away, beds made themselves, clothes hung themselves up, and soon the nursery was neat as a pin. Can you believe my bed made itself? And the toys marched up and hopped on the shelf, and clothes went on their hangers and put themselves in the closet. The children were delighted. Mary Poppins, you're so fun. The next day, it was going to be fun. We went to go see the sidewalk artist. I was drawing pictures in chalk when I looked up and saw Mary Poppins with the children. You're lucky children indeed. When you're with Mary Poppins, magic just seems to happen. How about a bit of magic right now, said Mary Poppins. No one is looking. Oh, really? If you must. Suddenly, we found ourselves inside of one of the sidewalk pictures at a county fair. All four of us took a ride on the carousel, and then Mary Poppins rode her horse right off the carousel, and ours followed her. We joined a fox hunt and entered a horse race. Oh my gosh! My horse in the carousel is flying up in the air, and we're on a fox hunt, and we're having so much fun. She's so much fun. And then that evening, after flying all over and playing on the horses and at the carnival fair, Mary Poppins tucked the children in. Oh, Mary Poppins, you're the best nanny we've ever, ever, ever had. Mom and Dad are so busy, and we have no one to play with and no one to hug. You are our best friend. Oh, that evening when Mary Poppins tucked the children in, oh, Mary, we promise. Promise, please promise us never leave. That's a pie-crusted promise, especially easily broken. I shall say until the winds change. Now go to sleep. Tomorrow you're going out with your father to the bank where he works. Jane and Mike were surprised. Really? Father never has taken us anywhere before. He never has time. He never has time for us. So they wanted to be with Mary Poppins, but they had to go with their dad. Bright and early the next morning, the children set off for the bank with their father, Michael, and had brought some coins with him to buy food for the birds, but Mr. Pigs wouldn't hear them. You must not put your money anywhere, did that. You must put it in the bank, and it will earn interest. Give it to me. All of a sudden, the outing with their father lost all the promise of fun, and Jane and Michael let go of his hands, and they ran off and got themselves lost. He's so funny, he's so mean. All he thinks is of money, money, money. I know we need money, 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 and money should make interest, but sometimes you just gotta have fun being a kid. It was a good thing they ran into me. That day it suited me to be a chimney sweep, and the children were happy to see me, but they were still upset. Oh, Bert, Father tried to take Michael's money. He doesn't like us at all. Oh. Listen, kids, your father loves you very much. He loves money? Yeah, everyone loves some money. And, you know, some people like to be a banker and, you know, keep all the money and interest, which is great for your future. But in the meantime, we will have a day cleaning the chimney. Before we even get started, Mary Poppins had a surprise for us. In a twinkle of eye, she whistles up the chimney and right into the rooftop. So we were dancing on the rooftop and playing with the brooms and sweeping. And we were playing with the brooms and we were sweeping and having fun. We were on top of the rooftop and we're dancing and singing. And we were having fun, fun, fun. La da 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 da. It's so much fun playing with my friends and pretending. I have my broom and I have my sweep. She is umbrella and it is fun. Da da bum bum, it is fun. Bum 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 bum, it is fun to play. It is fun to play. And you know what? Dad and Mom saw us and he said, you know what? Keep your money, Michael. I'll only be doing what I thought was best for you, but from now on, I see the money isn't everything, but having fun at your age is something that I'll really, really try harder to do. So he said, hey, let's go fly a kite. Really, Dad? Sure, let's go fly a kite. My money is making interest, so I have time to go play. Dad, you're so fun. I can't believe it. Then when the whole Biggs family went to the park together for the first time in a long time, they flew their kite and had a grand time. The wind changed and everyone was playing. And then up, up, up in the air, Mary Poppins flew with her umbrella and her big bag. And she said, goodbye, kids. Goodbye. Au revoir. Au revoir. I will be back again someday to play with you. The end.